If a ransom for many, the Lord Jesus surrendered himself to that and he scourged him. Why? Because by his stripes I am. By his stripes, by his stripes, I am healed. That's the reason why they release Barabbas. It's the picture that your release has come. Because Jesus Christ bore your punishment. Do you understand the fullness of Jubilee revelation? Number one, for you, for me, for us together, a year of rest. Number two, a year of return and reunion. Number three, a year of restoration. Number four, it's a year of redemption. Number five, a year of relief. Number six, a year of reckoning. And number seven, I am released, a year of release. It's today. I said it's today. Number two, the focus of Jubilee reflection. Now let's reflect on Jubilee. Jubilee reflection, Jubilee responsibility. What are we supposed to do as we reflect on what the Lord is calling us to in the year of Jubilee? The focus on Jubilee reflection. Leviticus chapter 25, I'm reading from verse 14. Leviticus chapter 25, we're looking at verse 14. And if thou sell aught unto thy neighbors, or buyest aught of thy neighbor's hand, ye shall not oppress one another. It's telling us that there is a Jubilee revelation, there is Jubilee reflection, a Jubilee responsibility. It says, nobody will oppress you and you will not oppress anybody. Nobody will steal from you, you will not steal from anybody. Nobody will be a problem to you, you will not be a problem to anybody. Because the year of Jubilee for everybody, for you, for me, for our loved ones, for our families, for our neighbors, is supposed to be a year of freedom. So nobody is going to hold any other person in captivity. Let's reflect about that. That as the freedom of the Lord is coming to you, that freedom you'll share it with other people too. Verse 17, ye shall not therefore oppress one another, but thou shalt fear the Lord thy God, for I am the Lord your God. Look at verse 18. Wherefore, ye shall do my statutes, and keep my judgments, and do them, and ye shall dwell in the land. How? Safety, safety. You'll not be a dangerous person, because nobody is going to post being a dangerous person to you. Because the year of Jubilee is for everybody. It's not only for you, it's for the person sitting by your side. It's for the person that is sitting behind you. Everybody living around you, the Lord wants everybody in safety in the year of Jubilee. Verse 39. And if thy brother that dwelleth by thee be waxing poor, and be sold unto thee, thou shalt not compel him to serve as a bond servant. It says, it's the year of Jubilee. As you don't want to be a servant and a slave, a prisoner in captivity, so you release your brother, your sister, your neighbor. You'll not be holding grudge against them, holding something against them. He did this against me. Hey, that's before the year of Jubilee. Now that the year of Jubilee has come, you forgive everyone. And then you allow your neighbor to enjoy their freedom. You allow your brother, your sister, your wife, your husband, your children to enjoy and celebrate their freedom, because the year of Jubilee has come. Verse 41, and then shall he depart from thee, both he and his children with him, and shall return unto his own family, and unto the possession of his fathers shall he return. Verse 42, for they are my servants, which I brought forth out of the land of Egypt. And it says, and they shall not be sold as bondmen. Thou shalt not rule over him with rigor. Thou shalt not rule over him with what? You know, there are people that the way they live, especially if they are, you know, if they have some little position, even some of us, like in the church, that have position in the church. It's like, I want everybody to fear me. That when you are coming, they say, so-and-so is coming. So-and-so is coming. In the year of Jubilee, all that is over. Because now we relax, and then you live your life. You're not afraid, pastor will catch me, and then he's going to put this heavy sin on me. It's the year of Jubilee. Nobody's going to put any heavy sin on you. You love your brother, you love your sister, your father in the Lord loves you, you love your father in the Lord, because the year of Jubilee has come. Nobody will oppress anybody in this church. And as you come in, whatever happened yesterday, forget about that. Year of Jubilee is what we are talking about. Whatever happened last year, that's all gone. Last year was not a year of Jubilee. This year is the year. I said this year is the year. You know, people, you have to change your spectacles now in the year of Jubilee, because if you're still wearing the same spectacles that you wore 2 years ago, 3 years ago, and it has a particular color, and then you come to the year of Jubilee, and then you're still wearing the same spectacles, you understand what I mean? In the year of Jubilee, you still see everything the way you used to see it. When the year of Jubilee comes, so change the lenses on your spectacle, because now you see bright, you see clear. I don't see oppression anymore. I don't see bondage anymore. I don't see imprisonment anymore. All I see now is rest. All I see now is reunion. All I see now is restoration. All I see now is redemption. All I see now is relief. All I see now is reckoning. All I see now is release. You are released. I said you are released. Do you know that in the year of Jubilee in Israel, the people that have been, we call it discipline, you know, imprisonment. And we say, stay there in the cooler. You'll stay there for the rest of your life if you're not careful. I'm telling you, when the year of Jubilee comes, we say, discipline is over. I said it's over. We say now, because Jesus Christ paid the price for you, the discipline is lifted. I said it is Jubilee. But you know, sir, he did this against you, did this against you. Don't worry about that, the year of Jubilee. Not to tell you, anybody that was sent away from the church, we don't want you in the church, I'm inviting them, come back. Because now Jubilee has happened. And you did that, you step on my toe, you stepped on my shoe, you put something on my clothes. Jubilee has come and we're released in Jesus' name. Because that's what the scripture said. We're not just going to read the Bible in the head and not put it into practice, and then in your own family, to any of your children, they did something that, you know, how did you do that? No more school fees. Yeah, Jubilee school fees has come back. And wife, get away. I don't want to see you anymore because of you spoke about my mother like that. You woman, get away. I don't want to see you anymore. Now our Jubilee has come. Sister, you can come back now. Brother, you can come back now. Let there be reunion in the year of Jubilee. Everybody say Jubilee. Look at verse 43 there. It says, thou shalt not rule over him with rigor, but shall fear the Lord thy God. The Lord is bringing restoration to us. And thank God you're still alive in this year of Jubilee. Help us tell the people who are not here today, tell them a new thing has come. Tell them Jubilee has come. Release has come. Forgiveness has come. God gives you forgiveness, and we support God. We agree with God. We cheer. We give you forgiveness. Isaiah chapter 1. I'm reading from verse 16. It says, wash you, make you clean, put away the evil of your doings from before mine eyes. Cease to do evil, learn to do well, seek judgment, and relieve the oppressed. Relieve the oppressed. That's what it's telling us. It's the year of our Jubilee. And then it says, in this place, it says, judge the fatherless and plead for the widows. Come now and let us reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. And though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. If he be willing and obedient, tell me the rest. He shall eat the good of the land. He shall eat the good of the land. And I want to tell you that you are going to eat the good of the land. The Lord himself has come to give us our jubilee and to give us our release. And as the Lord does that, I pray everything you have missed will come back to you in Jesus' name. Number three is the fulfillment of jubilee redemption. The fulfillment of jubilee redemption. We're looking at Leviticus chapter 25. Leviticus chapter 25. Leviticus chapter 25. We're looking at verse 32. Leviticus 25 verse 32. Verse 32. It says in verse 32, notwithstanding the cities of the Levites and the houses of the cities of their possession, may the Levites redeemed at any time. At any time, at any time. Any Levite, any Christian worker, anyone that had been serving the Lord, he became so poor that then he sold his possessions away. And now he says the year of Jubilee has come. If he didn't realize that on the first day, second day, third day, any time during that year of Jubilee, he may be able to have everything that the Lord has for him. He'll redeem it at any time. Verse 35. In verse 35 it says, and if thy brother be waxing poor and falling in decay with thee, then thou shalt relieve him, yea, though he be a stranger and a sojourner, that he may live with thee. No more segregation, no more pushing away, he will live with you. I said he will live with you. And the Lord will make his abundance to be upon your life in Jesus' name. Psalm 145, I'm reading from verse 9. 145 verse 9. The Lord is good to how many people? You have jubilee now to how many people? The Lord is good unto all. And his tender mercies are over all his works. Look at verse 14. The Lord upholdeth how many people? All that fall, and raises up all those that are bowed down. Look at verse 16. In verse 16, thou openest thine hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. You see, that was the year of Jubilee. Verse 18. In verse 18, the Lord is near unto all that call upon him, to all that call upon him in truth. Verse 19, he will fulfill. It will fulfill. It will fulfill the desire of them that fear him. You desire anything today? Any blessing today? Anything you are telling, Lord, I want this, I want this. In the year of Jubilee, well, no more, it's not like you're fasting and praying and crying and rolling on the ground. In the year of Jubilee, it just comes to you like that at the end of service, and then you go back home. Now I have rest. Now I have restoration. Now I have reunion. Now I have redemption. And now I have relief. And now I have reckoning. And now I have the release, and the blessing of God has come upon your life in Jesus' name. I'm going to read a story to you. It is in 2 Samuel chapter 9. 2 Samuel chapter 9. It illustrates what the Lord is telling us today about the year of Jubilee, about the rest, about the reunion, and about the restoration. He's telling us about the redemption, and about the relief and the reckoning, and about the release. Look at it in 2 Samuel chapter 9 verse 1. And David said, is there yet any that is led of the house of Saul, that I may show him the kindness, show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? Is there anybody in the house of Saul? David, you know what you're saying? Saul was a person that hated David, and he pursued after the life of David. He wanted to kill David. Not only that, he gave instruction to all his children, and he wanted his children to tell their grandchildren, to his grandchildren, anywhere you hear the name of David, get rid of that name, destroy that man. He hated David with a passion. And then taught everybody, he said, Jonathan, unto a foolish son that you are befriending this David, kill him. Because as long as he is king, is there, you'll never be king. That was the person, but now David became king. And now he said, is there anybody in the house of Saul? because of Jonathan, I'm going to show him kindness. And there was in the house of Saul, his servant, whose name was Ziba. And when they had called him unto David, the king said unto him, Adoth Ziba? And he said, Thy servant is he. And the king said, Is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I may show the kindness of God unto him? David said, I'm looking for somebody, I'm going to bless him. And the Lord is looking for you to bless you. You know, before the year of Jubilee, it's like you were searching for God and you were searching for blessing. In the year of Jubilee, the Lord is the one searching for you. He said, where is he? Did he come to church today? Where is she? Did she come to church today? I want to overload and offload some blessing upon his life. And Ziba said unto the king, Jonathan has yet a son, which is lame on his feet. Jonathan has a son, but David, you're a king. I'm sorry to say that this little child would have come to you, but how can you associate with somebody that has a deformity like that? You high on the throne. The only son that Jonathan has now we can bring to you is lame in his feet. And the king said unto him, where is he? And Ziba said unto the king, behold, he is in the house of Micah, the son of Amiel in Lodibah. And then it says in verse 5, and the king David sent and fetched him out of the house of Micah and of the son of Amiel from Lodibah. And when Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, was come unto David, he fell on his face and did reverence. And David said, Mephibosheth? And he answered, behold thy servant. And David said unto him, fear not. He was afraid that this David now is going to wipe out the whole house of Saul. This David is now in power, is now in authority. Because of that, he's going to look for everybody.